Hi, and welcome to Scope Month. Today is Thursday, March 23rd. I'm Daniel Bogdanoff, and we're going to be giving away another 6 1000X Series scopes. You can enter once per day at scopemonth.com. For today's scope tip, I thought we'd look at some of the lesser-known ways in which you can customize your scope. One of the cool options on the scope is you can tell your signals what to expand either around center screen or around the ground. So if I set it to expand around ground, which is how it defaults, the signal's gonna automatically expand around that ground point for channel one. So if I increase it, you're gonna see my waveform steps up. But if I instead expand this around center, and I move this up just a little bit, we're gonna see that the waveform is actually going to expand around the center of the screen instead of channel one's ground. Now this is pretty useful if you're looking at a small detail of your signal, but every time you go to scale into it, it flies off the screen. You can actually, with this mode, just move that segment that you want to see to center screen, zoom in on center screen, and get right to the detail of your signal. Another fun one is the screensaver. So you can go into the screensaver menu. You can set a bunch of settings on what logos show up, and you can even set it to user text. So if you have an InfiniVision scope with the Megazoom 4 ASIC, you should try setting your text to track and see what that does for you. You can also play around with the functionality of auto scale. So if you go into the auto scale menu, there's a fast debug mode, which we might talk about later, but you can also set which channels it auto scales. So you can have it to either be all channels or only the displayed channels. So sometimes on a scope, if you hit auto scale and there's some noise in the room or you have a probe that's kind of just hanging out, it's gonna try and auto scale that signal also. If you're having that trouble, you can just change it to only the displayed channels, and then your auto scale is only gonna work off of those channels and ignore all the other ones. And that was only three of the ways you can customize your scope. I highly encourage you to go back to your bench, play around with some of the menus in your scope, and let me know if you find anything cool. And now let's draw today's 1000X series winners. So we're gonna draw 6 winners, and while that's drawing, I'd like to remind you of the Test to Impress contest. If you don't wanna leave your scopes up to random chance, you can submit a video into the Test to Impress contest, tell us why you think you should win a scope. Those videos will be reviewed by a panel, and the panel will pick a grand prize winner and 2 runner-up prizes, and we'll be giving away some 3 higher-end scopes for that contest. So today's 1000X winners are Boris Heller, Emma Tornblum, John Severt, Gregors Dubinsky, Andy Wilson, and Marcus Klein. Congratulations to our winners. We'll be in touch with you shortly. And while you're here on YouTube, check out the new Double E's Talk Tech podcast that went live today. We're talking about producer and consumer risk. So if you're buying something, what assurances do you have that it's actually going to work the way you expect it to? And if you're producing or selling something, what assurances do you have that that product isn't going to come back to haunt you? Thanks for watching. That's all for today. Make sure you subscribe to the Keysight Oscilloscopes YouTube channel and tune back in tomorrow, where I'll be giving away 8 more scopes. I'll see you then. So I'm curious to hear what you guys think about the dichotomy of good and evil and how it relates to electrical engineering.